Welcome to a new facts video. In this video, we will look at the 10 most interesting facts about space. If you haven't watched the top 50 interesting facts about space, you need to know video, you can find it from the cards. Without further ado, let's move on to 10 interesting space facts videos. 10. Where does space begin? Outer space begins just 62 miles away. Although there is no strict official boundary as to where space begins, the Kármán line lies at 62 miles above sea level and is traditionally used as the beginning of space in space treaties or aeronautical record keeping. It is named after Hungarian-American physicist and aerodynamics pioneer Theodor von Kármán, who calculated in 1954 that at this altitude, the atmosphere becomes very thin and an aircraft must move at orbital speed to maintain lift. The Kármán line is located in the lower thermosphere, the fourth layer of the Earth's atmosphere. The thermosphere is characterized by extremely high temperatures, resulting from the absorption of ultraviolet radiation from the sun. In fact, we expect to encounter cold as we move away from the Earth, but in this layer, temperatures vary between 200 degrees Celsius and 500 degrees Celsius. Additionally, the Kármán route is a popular destination for commercial space tourism flights. Many companies are developing suborbital spacecraft that could carry passengers to the edge of space. 9. Traveling to the dwarf planet at the edge of the solar system. If you could fly to Pluto, the journey would take more than 800 years. Yes, this is real. When we compare the universe with our solar system, we feel like we are very small, but there is no need to go that far. Even our solar system is huge. Still, we can say this. It does not seem possible to exceed distances at the speed of light in the universe, but we can explore the solar system with new technologies and techniques. For example, the Voyager 1 probe, the fastest spacecraft ever built, traveled at 61,000 kilometers per hour, approximately 38,000 miles per hour. Voyager 1's journey to Pluto took approximately 9 years. Another example, the New Horizons spacecraft, launched in 2006 and passing by Pluto in 2015, used a gravity assist maneuver to increase its speed. This maneuver involved flying close to Jupiter and using Jupiter's gravity to increase its speed. As a result, New Horizons was able to travel to Pluto in just over 9 years. 8. Another interesting fact about Pluto. A day lasts 153.6 hours on Pluto, the dwarf planet located in the Kuiper Belt, where icy bodies exist beyond Neptune's orbit. This corresponds to 6 days, 9 hours, and 36 minutes. A day on Pluto takes a very long time due to its slow rotation rate. So why does Pluto rotate so slowly? Pluto's slow rotation is thought to be caused by tidal locking between Pluto and its largest moon, Charon. Tidal locking is a phenomenon in which the rotation of a celestial body is synchronized with the moon's orbit, meaning that Pluto always has the same side facing Charon. 7. Interesting information about the moon. Since there is no wind on the moon, the tire tracks and footprints left by astronauts and machines on the moon are still intact. The surface of the moon is also very dry, which helps preserve tracks and footprints. Scientists estimate that the tracks and footprints will remain there for millions of years. Additionally, the surface of the moon is covered with dark gray rocks, pebbles, and dust called lunar regolith. Lunar regolith is the loose, unconsolidated layer of rock and dust that covers the entire moon and is formed as a result of constant bombardment of the moon's surface by micrometeoroids and cosmic rays. Here's why I mentioned lunar regolith. Lunar regolith is a valuable resource for astronauts. They can be used to build shelters, roads, and other infrastructure. It can also be used to produce oxygen and water. But there is one thing that needs to be taken into consideration. Regolite is very abrasive due to its sharp particles. Therefore, spacesuits and other equipment used on the moon must be specially designed to withstand the corrosive environment. 6. A very interesting information about the Sun. The Sun's atmosphere is much hotter than the Sun's surface. Logically, we would expect the surface of the Sun to be hotter, but it is not. The Sun's visible surface, the photosphere, is between 10,000 and 5,500 degrees Fahrenheit, while its upper atmosphere has temperatures of 1 million to 2 million degrees Celsius. This is a huge temperature difference with little explanation. But NASA has several spacecraft looking at the Sun in this state, and has some ideas about how heat is produced. One of these is heat bombs, which occur when magnetic fields intersect and rearrange in the corona. Another is that plasma waves move from the surface of the sun towards the corona. This process is very effective in heating the plasma, which is the state of matter that makes up the sun's atmosphere. The surface of the sun is colder, because it is farther away from the corona, and the energy from the corona radiates into space as heat and light. 5. How big is the solar system? The distance between the Sun and the Earth is defined as an astronomical unit. One astronomical unit, AU, is roughly equal to 93 million miles or 150 million kilometers. Looking at this picture, the following question comes to my mind. Why are Jupiter and Saturn so far away, even though Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars are at relatively closer distances? That's because they formed early in the solar system, when the Sun was still surrounded by a disk of gas and dust. The gas and dust in the inner solar system were too hot for planets to form, but the gas and dust in the outer solar system were cooler. As gas and dust in the outer solar system cooled, they began to clump together. Over time, these clusters grew larger, and eventually formed Jupiter and Saturn. Jupiter and Saturn are so massive that they attract most of the gas and dust from the outer solar system. This leaves little gas and dust for other planets to form. This is why the planets beyond Saturn are much smaller. Another reason why Jupiter and Saturn are so far apart is their orbits. Jupiter orbits the Sun at a distance of 5.2 AU, while Saturn orbits the Sun at a distance of 9.5 AU. The orbits of Jupiter and Saturn are fairly stable because they are so far apart. If they were closer together, their gravitational forces would disrupt each other's orbits. Another interesting thing about Jupiter and Saturn is this. Some scientists say that Jupiter and Saturn switched places in the past. The story is briefly as follows. Jupiter and Saturn were much further away from the Sun in the past. They were attracted to the Sun and interacted with solar dust. With this interaction, Jupiter and Saturn were brought closer to each other, and this interaction caused Jupiter and Saturn to switch places. The more massive Jupiter migrated backwards, while the less massive Saturn remained closer to the Sun. If you are curious about this theory, you can research it as the Grand Tack model. As I said, this model is just a theory. There are even some contradictions. For example, Jupiter and Saturn were never close. 4. We know more about Mars and our moon than we do about our oceans. We have fully mapped 100% of the lunar surface of Mars and Earth, whereas we have only mapped roughly 5% of the ocean floor. Oceans cover approximately 71% of the Earth's surface, but only 5% of the ocean floor has been mapped. This is because the oceans are deep and difficult to explore. The depth of the Mariana Trench, the deepest point in the ocean, is over 11,000 meters above 36,000 feet. 3. The most interesting moon in the solar system. Triton is the only large moon in the solar system that orbits its planet in a retrograde direction. This means that it orbits Neptune in the opposite direction to which Neptune is rotating. Astronomers aren't sure why Triton orbits Neptune in this way. One theory is that Triton was actually a Kuiper Belt object captured by Neptune's gravity. Another theory is that Triton formed from material ejected during Neptune's collision with another planet-sized object early in the solar system's history. Regardless of how it formed, Triton's retrograde orbit makes it a unique and fascinating object. It is also one of the most active moons in the solar system, with geysers and other features thought to be caused by tidal heating from Neptune. 2. Interesting information about Uranus. Due to its unique tilt, one season on Uranus is equivalent to 21 Earth years. Additionally, the 97.77 degree tilt on Uranus's axis means that a day there lasts only 17 hours, 14 minutes, and 24 seconds. Uranus is the only planet in the solar system whose axis is tilted more than 90 degrees. This means that Uranus essentially orbits the Sun on its side. Uranus's tilt is thought to be the result of a collision with a large object early in the history of the solar system. This collision tilted Uranus and caused its axis to tilt. The tilt of Uranus has a number of interesting consequences. For example, it means Uranus will experience 6 months of sunlight followed by 6 months of darkness at each of its poles. This also means that Uranus seasons are very long, with each season lasting 21 Earth years. Uranus's tilt also affects its rotation. Uranus rotates around its axis every 17 hours and 14 minutes. However, due to its tilt, Uranus's poles are always either towards or away from the Sun. This means that while there will be day and night at the poles, there will be constant twilight at the equator. 1. The Sun makes a full rotation every 25-35 days. So for us, one full rotation on Earth is equal to one full day. However, it takes 25-35 Earth days for our giant sun to complete one full rotation. Also, another interesting information about the sun. The equatorial region of the sun rotates faster than the polar region, so how? The sun is a sphere, but it does not rotate like a solid body. Instead, it rotates differentially, with the equator rotating faster than the poles. This is because the sun consists of plasma, a gas made up of charged particles. The plasma at the equator is hotter and less dense than the plasma at the poles, causing it to spin faster. This differential rotation of the sun is important for many reasons. For example, it helps drive the solar wind, a stream of charged particles flowing from the sun, into space. The solar wind interacts with the Earth's magnetic field and atmosphere, and can cause auroras and other space weather events. The sun's rotation also affects Earth's climate. The sun's magnetic field is strongest at the poles, and this affects the amount of sunlight reaching Earth. For example, during periods of high solar activity, the sun's magnetic field is stronger, which can cause cooler temperatures on Earth. Yes. We have come to the end of the 10 most interesting facts videos about space. As I said at the beginning of the video, you can look at the cards for more space facts videos. Also, don't forget to like the video and subscribe. Bye.